Welcome back to EdTech School. Images are a great way to grab the attention of your students. Using good quality, high resolution images is super important, but what else can you do to make images more compelling? I'll teach you how to pimp your images like a pro. If you like my tips, be sure to give the video a big thumbs up. Take a look at Adobe Spark. This is by far my favorite image editing app. They make your images look super slick and it's just so easy. Like many other apps, you can add filters and text to images, but what's really great about Adobe Spark is that it has built-in styles you can simply cycle through. They make sure that the fonts, colors, filters and layout work well together, so all you have to do is click until you see a combination you like. What's also great is that they have a built-in library of free images. So it's an easy way to take a piece of text or a code and make it look very great quickly. On top of that, Adobe Spark makes it possible to create a beautifully designed web page, which you can use, for example, as student portfolios. Adobe Spark also supports a nice video editor, which is perfectly for students to demonstrate learning. Just insert your text, images, and little videos. Adobe Spark puts it all together and makes it sparkle. The price tag is sparkling too. This amazing tool is completely free. The second tool I'd like to show you is Canva. It's similar to Spark but with a bit more options. They provide thousands of beautiful layouts like magazine templates, presentations, letters, business cards, etc. Unfortunately, not all of these layouts are for free. You can search instantly for good images and icons. They also provide other elements like grids, frames, shapes, lines, and charts. You can get some of their images, icons, and other designs for free. And they offer a large range of premium ones as well. Don't worry, I have some great tips on where to find free, high-quality images on the blog. I'll put a link to that in the description. I use BookWidgets to make my images more interactive. Let your students really explore images and make them come alive. Here are a few widgets that will be useful in your classroom. The before-after widget lets you compare two images, slide over the image and see another one appear. Great for history lessons and geography, now and then. Language teachers use this to pair up students and let them describe the differences to each other. It's a great speaking exercise. To add video, pictures, text, audio, and webpage pop-ups to your images, use the hotspot image. It's a nice way to overlay extra information on top of a photograph or a painting. If you teach geography, give the image carousel widget a try. It's an image slideshow with hotspots and a Google Maps twist, letting you see the exact location of every image on the map. Want to let students have a closer look at an image? Zoom and pan around a large image with the image viewer. You'll need a high resolution image, but this is great for letting students explore images from a microscope, for instance. In language classes, you can use this for speaking exercises, for example, by using pictures with a lot of things going on. They can zoom in on different areas and describe what they see. The Spot the Difference widget lets you insert images with differences, so your students can find them. This isn't just for toddlers. In this example, we're using it to introduce students to the differences between an African and the Asian elephants. I hope this video helped you to spice up your images and grab the attention of your students. Make sure to subscribe if you like all these EdTech tips. Thanks for watching!